what our faculty was puzzled by, that on an average, no matter where we ran the program, in the first sessions, it took between 1 hour and 17 minutes to 1 hour and 21 minutes for participants to list honesty and integrity as qualities of good business leaders. When we made participants aware of this, what was their response? They got defensive. They got angry. They said, well, it is implicit. It is implicit that we are honest and that we have integrity. I said, well, the notion of vision is implicit in leadership. The notion of power of persuasion is implicit in leadership. Why should all those qualities come up, but honesty and integrity does not come up? And again, I don't believe that these people were dishonest individuals. But it is simply that they had not thought that of honesty that often. They had not thought about integrity that often besides that context. The second issue is that as a society, if we genuinely believe that in order to be a successful business leader, one has to have aggression, one has to have greed, one has to have power of deception, then we should regard it as normal qualities of succeeding as a business leader. We should go home and teach those qualities to our kids. By the time they're 8 years old, we should make them the most fulfilled, aggressive individuals as possible. By the time they turn 11, they should know everything about greed that there is, especially that there is not a concept known as enough. And by the time they turn 15, they should be the masters in power of deception. Then we are really preparing them to become good, successful business leaders, if we really regard those as criteria of leadership. But we do not do that. We operate in professional lives, oftentimes, under the premise that these are the necessities of the system that we are part of, to demonstrate this sort of behavior. And then when we go home, we try to demonstrate a very different kind of behavior, oftentimes radically different behavior. And there is the level of disconnect in our recognition of what leadership really means.